this just needs a so this needed a truss rod adjustment. With PRS, if you want to lower the action, we can just lower the entire bridge with these six screws here, and then we can raise up the saddles to get what we want. I always like to start from zero and go up. That's my way of doing it. So now we're just going to just lightly polish this. So I'm starting with micro mesh, and I'll just use my Dremel on this one. I'm starting at 2400 grit micro mesh, and the aim is not to take anything away, just to polish it up, make it super shiny and make it super smooth. It's a PRS, it's a real nice PRS actually, so it doesn't require much. It hasn't really been played. I can see a bit of wear marks down here, so you can actually see where the old owner used to play. He did a lot of open chords up here. I think he was a blues guy, judging by where he's playing, but PRS is really good fret material, which is fantastic. So yeah, we're just going to go over this with that. So now we find our next grade up, which should be this one, which is 3200. Now I want to be pretty quick. Want to get this done as fast as possible, because I don't want this tape on this finish for long. That makes sense. So we're actually going to skip a grade. We're going to go to... Where are you, bastard? Get that one out. When your micro mesh gets dirty, it can be difficult to find out which one's which. This one. This is 4000. Well, actually, not scripting again. Great, this is good. So 4000. Again, this is just a very light off the top kind of thing. Just making it super shiny, not taking anything off. Highly recommend everyone gets some micro mesh if they can. It's fantastic stuff. So now we want the purple one, which looks like that. Again, you can't really tell it's purple. I can. Purple is 6000 grit. Just keep going, make it shiny, shiny, shiny. We only need one pass of this stuff. It's really not doing anything but just giving it a buff at the top. Next we have 8000, just one pass. Finally, 12,000. Just one pass. You can do two if you want. Again, we're really not doing much. It's not going to make a difference if you go over it 50 times or a couple of times. Alright. Happy with that. Clean our desk up. Always try to keep a clean workspace. It's good for your health.
Have a sip of coffee.
Now,
I've got to get the Dremel out.
This is a bolt-on neck, but I don't feel like taking it off. So we're just going to use a Dremel. I've got it set to 3. Oh. And just try to cover the whole fret. In and out, not too much heat. Trying to go for it. You're looking for the fret to go a bit black. Perfect. You can instantly see the difference. If you use too much material, you can actually make the fret go hazy when you're polishing it, cleaning it off and wiping it down. So you do need to put more material on every now and then, but just try to use what you got until you can't use it anymore. As we approach this side, there's a bit of a build-up of gunk and corrosion, especially in these little pockets here, so just along the side of the fret. So that's when we kind of want to dig in. But remember, it's the philosophy of less. Less is more. Someday I wish.
spaceship, want a star, and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me.
Bag. I got this one. It's blue. I like blue. Now we wipe the first layer off, try to get in every single nook and cranny you can. So it just wipes away any compound that's left over on the fret, helps buff it up a bit. You can see the compound is black if you look for it, so anywhere that has a little black spot, white. We didn't apply too much compound to this, but there is a bit here I can see. Alright. A little bit here. Make sure you're staring at what you're doing. So that's just the frets with the Dremel. As you can see, super shiny, super awesome. Now, what I like to do, is I get some of this stuff, Dunlop 65. And I just dab a little bit on each fret, just like that. So this is a string cleaner, but you know, if it cleans strings, which is metal, it cleans metal really well. And this just helps get rid of any other little bits of polish. And it also lubricates the frets, so they feel even smoother. That's essentially just a bit of a soap, but a very metal friendly soap. Sort of like the fast fret stuff. Alright. And you know it's working because it's actually taking the polish off the tape. Alright. Now that's done, let's get the tape on. So I've also just put a piece of leather here. Just because as soon as you release the string tension, this bridge just slams right down at the back. We don't want anything to happen. The piece of leather just helps. So here's the frets before we actually oil the fretboard. The tape also takes away the first layer of residue from any previous conditioning. So just sprinkle some of this on. You can be pretty generous. I just go back and forth. Grab our dirty rag. You don't want to mix your clean rag with your dirty rag with this stuff. Just wipe it on, just like so. Get it right in there. The Music Nomad stuff is absolutely fantastic. I prefer it over Dunlop stuff tenfold. Highly recommended. Music Nomad have some great products. Alright, so now we just get our clean side of the rag. Start wiping it in. It also takes off excess. Get in there. This conditions it, shines it, makes it look pretty. Oh, there's a knot there. Interesting, there's a knot in that rosewood. Keep going. Alright. Go along the sides a bit just to wipe off anything that might have fallen in. There we have one clean fretboard. I just like to get my rag and just wipe here where the tape's been. I've got nothing on the rag at the moment, it's just a dry rag. Just wipe where the tape's been, just to pick up any residue. And that's that. So, with the fretboard polished and shined, it looks like that. You can see in the light how it reflects really well. It also reflects just about everything. There's the green rag coming through on the actual fretboard. It feels good, it looks good. It's what you want. This wasn't bad to begin with, but I just needed a little bit more. So next up is the restring. I'm going to go tens on this bad boy. Ernie balls. And I don't need to explain this bit. Thank you. sleep. Congratulations, new guitar. You're really going to enjoy it. Just needed a bit of it. Someday I wish.